Very warm welcome from my side. My name is Dr. Tom Assmann and I am research group lead at the University of Magdeburg for the research group on transportation and logistics systems. We are working in many research projects about autonomous cargo bikes, autonomous vehicles, about e-mobility and e-logistics and how we can create smart and sustainable mobility systems for the future. What we want to discuss today in the next 10 minutes is the issue of what are the innovators of urban mobility in Magdeburg? What is the smart mobility concept we are going to follow in Magdeburg? What are our plans for the future? What can we do and what can we offer as automotive e-mobility competences? But also, what do we have in the upcoming and also very promising field of autonomous smart mobility? When talking about Magdeburg, one often thinks about what comes from the city, what are innovative companies? And actually, Magdeburg has some very surprising innovative companies also from the mobility sector. And one of the most recent and one of the most famous innovators from the cities are bike companies, something which is a bit unexpected. But if you look at Schindelhauer, who originated from Magdeburg and founded their company here, they are now one of the leading bike manufacturers within Germany. Their bikes are kind of considered to be something like a Mercedes or an Audi for the bike sector. And a new company, which just recently started as a startup, as Urban Bikes, they are very famous for this specially designed frame. They even call it Fair Frame because it's a frame which is produced in Germany and it's a sustainable frame. And what makes this bike special is also that it's an intelligent bike. So they integrate all the electronical devices into the bike and it's not just attached. And this is one of the hottest startups in the bike business currently. So Magdeburg has strong innovators in mobility, and those innovators could grow because Magdeburg and the university I am working at are providing a great environment to develop things, to have ideas, and to get in contact with the people you need to get to know in order to make business. The University of Magdeburg is named after Otto von Guericke, the guy who actually discovered or invented the vacuum and follows this approach of being innovative, trying something new, and also trying something new which really is disruptive. Our university has 14,000 students. 4,000 of them are international students, many coming from India. And we are working at 9 different profiled faculties, focusing on topics from humanities, medicine, till electrical engineering, mechanical engineering, economics, and so on. So we have a broad range of competences, which also translate into 11 maker labs, small startup accelerators where people and students and others can go to if they have an idea and then say, okay, I want to test it, I want to try it, I have a new idea, and let's go forward. I also have two test beds for mobility innovations. One is in Galileo test bed where we can test the applications which go along with the Galileo navigation system, and now we are extending extending it to a 5G campus network so that we can use all the new mobility technologies in order to facilitate applications and also to test innovations within our campus area. And the university is not alone in the city. We have a strong network and we have other strong research institutions in the city, which is one Fraunhofer Institute, one Max Planck Institute, and Leibniz Institute, and an Helmholtz Institute. And additionally, there's also a University of Applied Science in the city. So the research and the development area and also the university landscape is broad and strong and provides great workforce as great researcher to collaborate with. Coming back to the smart mobility we are aiming for, what is our goal and our long-term objective is to create a smart mobility concept for the region of Magdeburg, and we want to transform Magdeburg to a smart mobility testbed in which we can develop small components, so intelligent transport components for logistic applications and for mobility applications like IoT devices and other things. We want to develop out of those components and in combining those components, intelligent transport systems till we reach a holistic intelligent area, smart mobility area of Magdeburg. And this is what makes us new, and what we aim for is not to just look at one mode of transport, but on how we can combine different modes of transport in a sustainable way, in a comfortable way, that people really start to use more sustainable transport. In detail, this means that we go from autonomous vehicles over the digital mobility campus or a 5G campus until issues we want to work with and we want to collaborate with you on business models, entrepreneurship, and sustainability and environmental aspects, or how we design future transportation infrastructure. This is one of our objectives, and we got strong competences from where we start. One is in the automotive sector. We have the Competence Centrum for e-mobility. It's a competence center focusing on basically cars, and here on three pillars. The first one is the drivetrain, and here we are focusing on testing conventional drivetrains and improving them, but also on developing electric drivetrains and also developing new and more efficient electric engines. We are focusing on the issue of how can you design a vehicle from scratch which is sustainable by design. And lastly, we are working on autonomous driving and how we can use this autonomous driving in test beds and what how it will change the way how we build cars. If we go a bit deeper into those fields, drivetrain, autonomous driving, and vehicles, the competences we can offer go from system design to construction, to connection technologies, to test and integration platforms, to cooling of vehicles and of drivetrains, to car acoustics, car design, and all the aspects which are actually related with making, designing, producing a great vehicle. This is the one side. And the other strong research area is autonomous mobility. And in autonomous mobility, we are following a different approach than basically people are doing and expecting. What we know from research on the perceived as effect of autonomous vehicles and shared autonomous fleets is that actually they are not very likely to solve the traffic problem. People will use more cars and will use cars for longer distance if we just transform our current car fleets to autonomous car fleets. So the problem of congestion will still be there. So this motivates us to follow two different approaches. One is autonomous buses and autonomous bus and public transport. And the other one, and here we come back to the issue of bikes, are autonomous bicycles and how we can make bicycles autonomous and how we can transform them to the future of mobility. With the autonomous bikes, with the autonomous buses, we are working on two projects currently. One is in Stolberg, a wonderful small town in the Harz region. If you come to Magdeburg, you should also pay a visit there. It's great for a day visit. And the second project actually is going to start this month in the city of Magdeburg, where we will use this autonomous bus to drive to inner city park of Magdeburg. And this is our autonomous bike. And actually, yes, it is driving. It is the first generation bike. We have many more generations now in operation. And here we are aiming for a new mobility on demand system. If you need a bike, you just take out your app. Yeah. Ask your app for a bike, and then the bike comes to you. And as soon as the bike arrives at your location, you take over the bike, you ride manually to your final destination, then you release the bike just goes to the next customer. This is the basic idea of the work we are doing with the autonomous bikes, and here we are actively looking for collaboration and for companies wanting to work with us on getting this idea of an on-demand, more sustainable autonomous transport system to reality. This is our team. And my last very small point is on the market potential you will have if you go to Magdeburg. As outlined briefly, Magdeburg has no strong mobility company itself currently. We have those great innovators, but if you look at on the map, you are close to big companies like Continental, Volkswagen, Porsche, BMW doing cars, but you are also very well connected to Berlin, which is the city of most mobility startups, to Leipzig, where Nextbike, one of the biggest bike sharing company of the world, is located, and you have a great connection to the biggest DHL hub in the world, connecting your goods to every place on Earth in nearly 24 hours. So this is what the city of Magdeburg can offer. I wrapped it up briefly. We are a city with a very strong technical education, with a very strong innovation culture, and we are looking forward to welcome you in the city, which provides marvelous living conditions and is closely connected to all the other German hotspots. Thank you very much, and I'm looking forward to welcome you in Magdeburg.